As you all know, Krishna Baladeva Prabhu, he has been giving the Sunday morning lessons for many, many years.
大家都知道, Krishna Baladeva Prabhu, 也就是我们的阿叔, 已经很多很多年以来在星期天为我们讲述圣殿不加瓦坛的早课了。
But today we're going to have three of our senior overseas devotees share together.
但是今天我们会有来自海外的三位年长的奉献者一起来为我们分享。
So we're going to do this once a month. Our plan is to do this once a month.
那这样的课程呢,我们会一个月安排一次,这是我们现在的计划。
We thought it would be nice for the community of devotees to see, you know, our senior devotees and initiating spiritual masters having sanghas together.
因为我们觉得，如果要是我们社团里面的奉献者能够看到我们启迪的灵性导师以及这些年长的奉献者能够一起同时和我们联谊的话呢，会是很有益的一件事情。Hence
this arrangement.
所以才会有这样的安排。Of
course, each of them, they have their individual sharings online during the week, but we thought it would be nice for all of us to have them do together.
但是每一位年长的奉献者在这一周里面呢，他们都会有自己单独的课程。但是我们觉得，如果他们要是一起能够共同和我们一起分享的话呢，也是一个很好的事情。So
once a month, we have this plan, and each time, three devotees. Three of them together.
所以我们会有这样的一个安排，就是每个月会安排一次，然后每一次呢会有三位不同的奉献者一起和我们分享。And
they will speak on a particular theme, a particular topic.
他们会讲述一个特别的主题。They'll
share together, and then of course we encourage all of you, the audience, to ask questions related to the topic.
他们会和我们一起来分享这同一话题，然后呢，我们也鼓励在听的所有的奉献者能够就他们所谈的话题提出相关的问题来进行呼应。So
questions that you do ask, please keep them within the topic.
所以大家要有问题提出的话呢，请大家一定要根据这个话题来提出问题。So
today, this morning, we have Narasingha Maharaj, Mahatma Prabhu, and Giridhari Swami. They are the three speakers for this morning.
所以我们今天早晨邀请的三位讲述者呢，是Narasingha Maharaj, Giridhari Maharaj, 以及 Mahatma Prabhu.
And then the following month, we'll have another three devotees share.
在下面的那个月的那一周，我们会安排另外三位奉献者和我们来分享。
In the past, sometimes in the past, when we all used to visit in Mayapur, when we could go to Mayapur, sometimes we would arrange these kinds of sanghas where many of us together, many of them together, and the devotees in Mayapur, we would have some sangha together.
在之前我们能够去Mayapur的时候呢，我们也会有这样的三个的联谊，就是我们会邀请各位年长的奉献者、灵性导师和我们一起来联谊。But
we haven't been able to do that, and for the last 2 years now, and it's quite possible we may not be able to do that for another 1 or 2 years. It's quite possible.
在过去的两年里呢，我们都没有办法去到Mayapur来做这样的联谊，而且很有可能在接下来的一年或两年里面，我们依然是没有办法去Mayapur的。Hence
this arrangement. So we have some together sangha online. Everything is online now. So we'll have this together sangha online.
所以说我们才会有这样的网上的安排，因为现在呢，所有的一切都要通过网络来完成，所以我们现在就有这个网络联谊。
So we are happy to have, again, Narasingha Maharaj, Mahatma Prabhu, and Giridhari Swami.
所以呢，我们非常的荣幸今天能够邀请到Narasimha Maharaj、Mahatma Prabhu以及 Giridhara Maharaj。
The theme of our topic for today is about unity and cooperation。
那么今天我们要讨论的题目呢是团结与合作。
And also, as time allows, with a little bit of mixing up with guru groupism.
那如果要是时间允许的话呢，我们也会夹杂着谈一些关于guru团的guru群体化的话题。
So, we're going to ask each of our speakers to 10 or 15 minutes on the topic, and then we'll open it up to questions.
那我们现在呢，就请每一位讲述者为我们就这个话题讲述10到15分钟的时间。然后呢，我们就可以听大家提出的问题了。
So we would like to invite Narasimha Maharaj first.
所以首先呢，请我们来邀，我们先邀请 Narasimha Maharaj 为我们讲述。
And then Giridhari Swami, and then Mahatma Prabhu, in that order.
之后呢是 Giridhara Maharaj, 然后呢是 Mahatma Prabhu, 我们是以这样的一个顺序的。
So, thank you, Maharaj. Narasimha Maharaj, you're welcome to begin, please. Thank you.
Om Jnana Tamarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripasindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha.Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare So speaking on the topic of unity and cooperation, we are reminded how Srila Prabhupada said the purpose of coming to Mayapur every year for the GBC members anyway, those in the GBC body, that they would come together every year to discuss how to create unity out of diversity.
那我们现在要谈论的是关于团结和合作的话题，这样就让我想起了Srila Prabhupada他如何每年的时候呢，会邀请 GBC 的成员来到马尔普，然后大家一起来商讨如何在多元化的状况下来进行团结的合作。
Now certainly there's a lot of diversity in our ISKCON society.
那当然在我们的 ISKCON 的社团中呢，是有很多的多样化的。
And certainly even we look at the spiritual teachers, we're so different.You know, there's such a big difference between someone like me and somebody like Mahatma and Giridhari Swami. You know, there's a lot of diversity.
而且呢，当我们在寻找我们的灵性导师的时候，也会发现灵性导师之间是有各种各样的区别和特征的。比如说，我本人和 Giridhara Maharaj 以及 Mahatma Prabhu 之间呢，就有很多的区别，很多的不一样的地方的。
You could say, well, we're all Westerners and we have the fair skin and blue eyes usually, but there's still so much difference, such big difference.
那你可以看到我们有一个共通点，就是我们都是西方人，而且呢，我们的这个皮肤的颜色很浅，我们大部分人呢都有蓝色的眼睛，但是我们依然还是有很多的区别的。
But the one thing which we do have in common is that we're all devoted to Lord Krishna, and we're followers of Srila Prabhupada.
但是呢，我们的确有一个共同点，那就是我们大家都是 Sri Krishna 的奉献者，我们都是 Srila Prabhupada 的追随者。
And we see Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukadeva Goswami, and Maharaj Parikshit they have a lot of diversity too. And the only thing they had in common was that they were both devoted to Lord Krishna.
而且我们从圣典伯加瓦坛里面能够看到，除了 Shukadeva Goswami 和 Parikshita 王之间也是有很多的不同之处的，但是他们有一个共同点，就是他们都是主 Krishna 的奉献者。
But Shukadeva Goswami and Maharaj Parikshit coming together, the result was that Srimad Bhagavatam could be spoken, and we're relishing the benefit of that today.
但是呢，当去了 Shukadeva Goswami 和 Parikshita 王他们在一起的时候呢，所产生的结果就是由圣殿布加瓦坛被讲述了出来，而我们今天呢，才有这个机会来品味圣殿布加瓦坛中的甘露。
So we can appreciate also the importance of what we're doing as members of ISKCON and pioneering the Krishna consciousness movement into a country.As diverse as China.
那所以说我们也就能够理解作为国际 Krishna 知觉协会中的这个成员，作为在中国的Krishna 知觉运动的先锋，我们的重要之处了。
We want to be very cautious about showing the right example to all of the devotees that.We are encouraging them to cooperate, and certainly ourselves also as spiritual teachers, as teachers for the devotees, we have to also be very much concerned to show them the right example.
那我们呢就要非常的小心的要为社团里的奉献者要建立一个好的榜样，并且呢要鼓励社团中的奉献者要很好的合作。那与此同时，我们也要非常小心我们自己在传播 Krishna 知觉的时候，在和别人在进行教导的时候，我们要彼此之间相互的合作团结。
Yeah, as the common saying goes, united we stand, divided we fall. Certainly, this is very much true in our attempts to introduce Krishna consciousness anywhere in the world.
那么团结会让我们站立，而分歧会让我们摔倒。那么这个是在我们传播 Krishna 知觉，以及在其他的这个在世界的其他的方面，其实都是一个不争的事实。
We want to cooperate. Operation function and co coming together, so functioning together as a body.As part of the body, just like in the Varnashram system, the different Varnas are meant to cooperate together for the social body.
那我们呢是要一起 cooperation 是运作，就是我们要一起来运作。那么就好像是在四社会阶层四灵性阶层体系的这个 Varnashram 体系之中也是一样的，我们要彼此之间相互合作的。来服务整个的这个社会之区社会体系。
So similarly in our efforts to try to introduce Krishna consciousness into China, we want to put great importance onto this aspect of unity and cooperation.
所以说呢，当我们在向中国传播 Krishna 知觉的时候呢，我们就要特别的强调这一点。我们要特别的强调在一起的团结与合作。
We have also Srila Prabhupada's final instruction to us before he left the world, that your love for me will be shown by how you can all cooperate together with each other after I am gone.
我们还有 Srila Prabhupada 在临终前对我们最后的训示，他的最后的训示就是说，你展示我。就是你们展示对我的爱的方式，就是来展示你们到底有多么的一起合作。
So as far as I understand the situation, that if we want to have unity, we have to have the common center, and the center is Srila Prabhupada and Lord Krishna.
那么就我所理解呢，就是如果我们要是想要有团结的话，也就意味着我们必须要有我们共同的。中心，那么这个共同的核心呢，就是说了 Papa 的，以及是 Krishna。
I thought it was one of the very wonderful things, wonderful achievements of the ISKCON Disciple Course to stress the position of Srila Prabhupada and the importance of keeping Prabhupada as a spiritual master for all the devotees in the Krishna Consciousness Movement.
那我们在ISKCON的门徒课程的美妙之处就在于要多么地强调了舍勒帕帕的重要地位，以及如何把舍勒帕帕的始终放置在我们所有人的灵性导师的地位之上。And
I personally like to try to connect all the devotees to Srila Prabhupada and help them to develop appreciation for Prabhupada.
那我自己本人呢，就愿意把所有的奉献者都和舍勒帕帕连接在一起，并且呢，使他们培养出对舍勒帕帕的感激以及赞赏之情。I
consider this to be one of my main function, main duties as a spiritual teacher.
那我认为这个对我来说，作为一名灵性的老师，是我重中之重的责任。
Of course, how we do this and how we go about doing this, it will be different. Certainly, there will be different approaches, how we're going to do it. You know, devotees, every devotee has their own unique talents.
那当然我们如何这么做到呢？其实我们是有各种各样不同的方式的，因为每一位贡献者都有自己独特的才华。
And we don't want to restrict a devotee from utilizing his own initiative and his own talents and creativeness in achieving these goals.
那我们不希望来限制住奉献者去运用他的才华以及他的能力来达到这个目标。
We're not against the disciples having devotion for the guru. So when we speak of Guru Bhakti, it's not a bad thing, it's a very good thing.
而且呢，我们也不想反对奉献者表达他对他自己guru的一片奉爱之情。所以说，当我们在讲述Guru Bhakti对guru的奉爱的时候，并不是一件坏事。And
I'm sure in the future there will be many, many more spiritual teachers.
而且我也很肯定在将来会有越来越多的灵性的老师。
And the need for cooperation and unity among all of these teachers is vital for the health of our society.
所以说呢，所有的这些灵性导师之间的团结与合作，对我们的社团的发展是非常重要的。
So I think this program today, bringing us together, it's a very nice idea, and I think it's, we hope the devotees also will appreciate this.
所以呢，今天的这个节目就是由我们一起来和大家分享的这个节目呢，我觉得是一个非常好的主意。那我也希望在座的所有的奉献者们也认为这个主意是一个很好的安排。Okay,
so I'll stop there.
我就先讲到这里。
Thank you, Maharaj. Giridhara Swami, you can be next. Thank you.
谢谢 Maharaj. Giridhara Maharaj, 请您是下一位讲述，谢谢。
Hare Krishna, dear devotees, and good morning.
Hare Krishna, 亲爱的奉献者们，早上好。
Please accept my humble obeisances, all glories to Srila Prabhupada.
请接受我非常谦卑的顶礼，一切的荣耀都归于Srila Prabhupada。
Srila Maharaj hit on a very essential point.
Srila Maharaj 刚才就说了一个非常重要的要点。
And that is that all members of ISKCON are duty bound to cooperate.
也就是在ISKCON的所有的成员的职责都是要合作。
That is, of course, if we have love for Srila Prabhupada.
那当然这是来自于我们对Srila Prabhupada的爱。
Because he made this point very clear, and it was just within the last few days of his manifest presence in this world.
他把这一点表达得非常的清晰，而且呢，当他在世界的，就在这个世界的最后这几天里面，他也表达了这个意见。
said, your love for me will be shown by how well you cooperate together after my departure.
那么他就说到呢，你们对我的爱将通过在我离世之后你们之间的合作而表达出来。
So I often think of that as a central point.
所以我经常把这个想到是一个非常重要的一点。
Like the example the Prabhupada gave, if you have a center point, and from the center point, if you use a compass, you can draw many concentric circles. And if the point is the same for all of them, then none of the circles will collide.
那么这个其实就是那个中心点，那么就好像是我们通过这个中心点可以画出很多很多的这个和同心圆，然后很多这个同心圆呢，它们也都会有重叠的地方。
So if our center point is Srila Prabhupada and of course Lord Krishna, then there'll be less likelihood of conflict.
那所以如果我们的中心点是Srila Prabhupada，也就意味着是Krishna。
And so this has to be emphasized. The consciousness of Srila Prabhupada as the founder Acharya, emphasizing the instructions that he gave to us, studying his books.
那所以说呢，我们就必须要强调这一点，就是这样的知觉必须是在这儿的。 那我们要意识到，Srila Prabhupada他是我们的创办灵性导师，他所给我们的所有的这些教导，以及我们很重要的需要去研习他的书籍。And
all devotees of ISKCON, regardless of what position they may occupy, are all followers of Srila Prabhupada, and they have to follow his instructions, and ultimately that they want to please him through their service.
在ISKCON的所有的奉献者们，无论他处在哪一个位置，那么终极来说呢，他都是Srila Prabhupada的追随者，那他都要去履行Srila Prabhupada的训谕，那么最终呢，他是需要通过他的服务来取悦Srila Prabhupada的。So
the more that we can make ISKCON Prabhupada-centric, if I can use that term, the further we'll be able to have unity and cooperation amongst all the members of ISKCON.
那所以说，如果我们要是时刻记得Srila Prabhupada他是我们的这个平均圆的话，那么在整个的这个ISKCON的这些成员之中呢，我们就会接踵而来的会有团结，会有合作。Now
we have a particular challenge in China.
但是在中国呢，我们有一个很特别的挑战。
We don't have temples, we don't have ashrams.
也就是说我们没有庙，没有修院，没有ashram.
And therefore devotees haven't had that exposure.
那所以说呢，这个奉献者他就不可能去到这些地方.
They haven't
Recording in
focus
progress.
On Diksha Guru, not enough on Srila Prabhupada as a founder Acharya, and not enough on other senior devotees as Shiksha Gurus.
那所以这样的事情呢，它就会导致一个问题。我相信导致的问题就是，使得奉献者就太多的会专注在自己的 Diksha 启迪功路上，而没有真正的去意识到 Srila Prabhupada 作为创办灵性导师对我们的意义。 以及呢，不会去想更多的去和我们的这个众多的Shiksha Guru之间的联谊。So
for many, I don't want to say all, but for many, they have more of the focus on Diksha Guru, and it's become almost Diksha Guru centric rather than Prabhupada centric.
那么我想呢，有很多的奉献者，由于他们过多的 去重视自己的 Diksha Guru 启迪灵性导师，所以说呢他们就把自己的启迪灵性导师作为了这个同心圆里面的那个圆心，而没有把 Sharapapa 的作为圆心了。
And it's created almost little movements within the movement.
这样的话呢就使得在这个运动中又掀起了小的运动。
Sometimes this may be more subtle and sometimes very gross.
有的时候呢就是这样的展现呢是很精微的，但有的时候呢展现出来的是很粗糙的方式。
We all have stories to share.
我们所有的人都可以有故事可以讲。
But I was quite surprised, I would say, I won't say shocked, I'm not shocked by anything, but I was quite surprised that, and I just heard this a couple of days back, where one disciple of Swami X, you know, canvassing so strongly for her guru that she kind of laid down an ultimatum to a would-be disciple saying, you have 1 hour to decide. Guru Mars is going to do an initiation. You have 1 hour to decide. So you better decide quickly here.Such chances don't come so often. You better take the opportunity. You have 1 hour to decide.
那么我就是虽然我已经不会被所有的事情而感到震惊，但是呢，就是我几天之前听到的一个事情让我觉得还是很惊讶，就是有这么一位奉献者，他非常的支持他自己的guru，所以说呢，他有一次就他就对这个新奉献者就说。现在呢你还有一个小时的时间来决定你是不是想从我的咕噜这里得到启迪，因为呢得到我咕噜的启迪的这种机会是非常罕见的，你现在只有一个小时了。
This poor devotee felt, you know, so disturbed, so disappointed.
那么这会儿就这位可怜的这位奉献者呢他就觉得心意很被打扰，而且呢觉得很失望。
And so pressured, but ultimately he didn't cave into that pressure, and he decided, no, I'm not going to be pressured into this. It's something that I have to think about deeply, and it has to be my choice.
但是最终呢，他没有承受这份压力，他就觉得这个是我自己的选择，所以呢，我需要花更多的时间来思考，所以呢，我现在先不接受这次的这个启迪。
So.It's my strong belief that all the devotees who are taking the position of Diksha Guru or Shiksha Guru or those who are acting as mentors and guides to devotees, you know, should actually instruct those devotees you have influence over to not canvass, to allow everyone to follow the natural process of hearing from...several senior devotees and let the individual make the decision. Don't try to make the decision for them.
那我相信所有的这些启迪的奉献者们，特别是作为其他的奉献者的指导老师的这些奉献者们，他都应该去鼓励所有的奉献者不要加入到自己的那个咕噜的那个团队里面，而是要鼓励所有的奉献者去聆听其他的这些奉献者的教导。然后让他们自己去决定应该是怎样的去选择。
And if we continue to just go down the same path as we've been traversing for years and years of, not in all cases, but in at least some cases, the devotees canvassing and all of this, it just creates disunity. It also creates Vaishnav aparad, no doubt about it, offenses. And therefore, you know, we wonder, why aren't we making advancement or not making advancement as quickly as we should be?
所以说如果我们要是继续像以前那样去走我们之前的这个错路，而且呢就是要使这个奉献者他要加入到这个不同的这个派别中的话，那我们可能就会导致之间的不团结，甚至于会导致奉献者的 upright 奉献者的冒犯。那如果这样的话，那我们肯定也就 不用去去困惑为什么我们到现在为止没有在灵性的道路上取得进步了。
So of all of the devotees, senior devotees who are occupying these positions, again, of Diksha, Shiksha, mentors, guides, can be of the same kind of mindset of putting Prabhupada in the center and allowing devotees to go through the natural process of hearing and then selecting on their own, and not putting pressure, not creating the camps. It will go a long way towards cooperation and unity amongst all the members.
那所以说呢，所有的处于 Diksha、Shiksha 或者是指导老师的这些奉献者们，都应该有同样的这种心态，有同样的做法，就是把 Srila Prabhupada 作为我们的核心，然后呢，指导奉献者们去聆听更多的聆听 Srila Prabhupada 的这个教导，然后让他们自由的。自发的去选择他们到底要找自己的哪一位guru，而不是我们去创造出一些派别，然后呢去创造出我们自己的这个组群，从而呢使我们导致在这个不团结的这样的状态下。
So this should be burned in our consciousness.
因为这个它会烧掉我们的知觉的。
That if we want to please Srila Prabhupada,we have to cooperate, and we cooperate by putting Prabhupada in the center.
So, if we want to please Srila Prabhupada, we have to cooperate. So, we cooperate by putting Prabhupada in the center.
And teach everyone else that we have influence over to do the same.
And teach everyone else that we have influence over to do the same.
So those are some thoughts I have this morning.
那所以呢，这是我今天早晨所有的一些想法。
Thank you for the opportunity.
非常感谢给我这样一个机会。
Thank you, Maharaj. So we'll move on to Mahatma Prabhu now.
非常感谢 Maharaj, 所以我们先请 Mahatma Prabhu。
But
you're mute, we cannot hear you.
Namaste, Saraswati Devi, Gauravani Pacharine, Nervises, and Badi Pacharine. Ukam Karati Vachalam, Pungulam, Veti, Girin, Kupatam, Hambande, Sigara, Dina Tariram. Panchakapata, the stock of our Sundavija, Patitanam, Pavanebio, Bashnavibio, Sikrishna.Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shyadvaita Gadadhar Shivashri Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare Hare Nice to be here with all of you and with my God brothers.
在这里能够和大家在一起感觉真好，而且能够和我的神兄弟们在一起感觉真好。
I think this class is exceptionally important for all of us.
那我觉得就今天的这节讲课呢，对于我们所有人来说都是非常重要的。
The senior devotees that are in our movement are quite concerned about the future of ISKCON.
那么在我们运动中的这些年长的奉献者们呢，对于 ISKCON 的将来也是非常的着想和担忧。
And we understand the future is tied into our ability to cooperate.
那我们也知道这个将来呢它就取决于我们到底有多么的合作我们合作的能力。
I want to better read you something Prabhupada said, quite amazing.
那我呢现在想给大家读一点事儿爸爸所说的所写的话非常的令人惊叹。
Srila Prabhupada said, cooperation is the essence of this movement.
Srila Prabhupada 说呢合作是这个运动的实质。
That's very heavy.
那么这是很力量很重的一句话。
Why did Prabhupada say it's the essence of the movement?
那为什么说了爸爸说团结是这个运动的实质呢或者说是精髓呢
Because he understood clearly from his own experience that without a high level of cooperation, a movement will self-destruct. due to quarrel, internal fighting and quarrel.
因为呢，从他自己的这个经验来知道，他说如果要是没有非常高层面的团结的话，那么这个运动它一定是会通过争执而崩塌的。
Prabhupada made another point, which is extremely important, and I will read what he said.
那么释迦牟尼佛呢，他还提出了另外一个要点，那么也是非常的重要的，我来读一读。
We are introducing Krishna consciousness movement for the harmony and goodwill of humanity.
那我们呢是为了人类的和谐以及福祉，所以呢才向大家介绍 Krishna 知觉的。
But if you yourselves are suffering from the very ills we are trying to remove,
但是如果你们本人都在为我们努力要移除的这些病痛而受苦的话，
How can the people be influenced favorably?
那么这些人们又怎么能够有益的被影响呢？
So Prabhupada was referring to devotees fighting.
所以在这里呢，说实话他指的是奉献者之间的打斗。
So while Nrisimha Maharaj and Giridhari Swami were speaking, I made a note of something I want to share with you.
那么当你心和马尔智和吉达马尔智在讲话，在刚才在分享的时候呢，我就做了点笔记，我现在想和大家来分享。
In everything we do, and in everything we say, we can ask ourselves a question.
那么我们无论说什么，做什么，我们总是先要问自己一个问题。
And the question is, are we creating more unity? Or more division by our words and action.
那么我们所说的话以及我们所做出来的这个行为，到底是会导致更多的团结呢，还是会导致更多的分裂呢？
Sometimes what we're doing may be of value in a specific situation, but within the whole yatra or the whole country, it actually could be creating division.
那么有的时候呢，我们所做的事情可能对于我们的这个小团体来讲，可能是会有一些价值的，但是对于整个的这个亚洲来讲，它可能就会是产生分歧，产生分裂。
So, example Maharaj gave that a devotee may be serving their guru.
比如说刚才 Maharaj 给了我们这么一个例子，就是一位奉献者，他可能是在服务他自己的 guru Maharaj。
But in the name of service, they may be doing something which is fostering disunity in the movement.
但是呢，他打着服务的这个旗号，他做的这个事情呢，使得他可能就会和整个的这个运动会起有更大的纷争。
Yeah. Now, Prabhupada has given us the reason.That we don't get along.
那说爸爸他告诉了我们为什么我们不能够彼此之间相互合作的原因。
And he's made it very clear.
他讲得很清楚。
This is from a letter. The reason why there is difficulty and competitive spirit is that everyone wants to be supreme.
那他在信中就写到了，他说之所以呢。会有这个分歧，以及会有彼此之间的合作的困难的原因呢，是因为所有的人都想成为至尊。
It may be difficult to admit.
也许要承认这一点挺难。
But we all want to be God.
但是我们所有人都想成为神。
And Prabhupada is saying that's the main reason we don't get along.
舍利帕帕说这就是我们不能够彼此之间相互合作的最主要的原因。
Sometimes we may have to compromise.
但是有的时候呢，我们可能不得不要做出妥协。
And that's difficult.
但这挺难。
But if that compromise brings unity, then that compromise is the highest truth.
但是如果要是这个妥协能够带来团结的话，那么这个团结它就是最高的真理。
whatever will bring unity, Prabhupada said that unity is essential. So that's the highest principle.
邵爸爸说, 就是任何一件事情能够带来团结, 因为这个团结它是最重要的, 所以这就是最高原则。
So, just in case you think I'm making something up, I want to read something else. What Prabhupada, he's quite clear about how the fighting will destroy us.
为了避免你们认为我是自己编出来的，那我现在要给大家来读一点说帕帕的其他所写的东西。那么他非常清晰地指出，这个争吵如何会毁灭。
Let us try to work cooperatively, otherwise the fighting spirit will ruin our great movement.
那么让我们要合作，否则的话呢，这个争斗的这种情绪就会毁掉我们的运动。
Something Srila Bhaktisiddhanta said that we can all meditate on.
Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur他说了一些话，我们所有的人都可以去冥想他所说的这个话。
He said, the reason that I criticize others is because I have no humility.
他说呢，之所以我会批评其他的人的原因，是由于我完全没有谦卑。
I think we can all agree that if we had a little more humility, we would get along better.
那我们大家其实都可能会同意这一点，就如果我们要是有一点点谦卑的话呢，我们就能够和其他的人友好相处。
There's a few things we can do. I'll just give you a few ideas and you can meditate on this. One of the main reasons we don't get along is we make assumptions about others.
其中有一个我们不能够和别人友好相处的最主要的原因，是因为我们会对别人发出假设。
Or we hear something bad about someone and we just believe it.
或者说的，我们会听到一些其他人的那些坏话，然后我们就会相信。
So don't make assumptions about others unless you want to understand properly a person before you make assumptions.
所以呢，我们不要对别人设立这种假设。 那么，当我们在设立假设之前呢，我们最好是能够更好的先去了解一下这个人。
And don't make assumptions about people's motives.
而且呢，也不要去假设这个人的动机。That
is really bad.
因为这真的很不好。Now,
Nisinga Maharaj was talking about unity and diversity.
那么刚才你信刚才你信和 Maharaj 就探讨了关于团结和分裂。
And how we're all different.
所以呢，我们每一个人都有自己的差别。
Not everyone in the world is going to see things the way we see things.
那所以说，在世界上呢，没有任何一个人会以我们同样的角度去看世界。
In order to get along, it's essentially important that we try to understand the viewpoint of another devotee.
所以呢，为了要让我们能够友好相处，我们就应该努力的去了解其他的奉献者他的立场、他的看事的观点。
It doesn't mean we have to agree to understand, but we need to understand.
这并不意味着我们就要同意别人的这个想法。那我们，但是我们需要去理解。
We can have two different points of view. We can understand one another, and we can still get along.
那我们可以有不同的观点，然后呢，我们可以这个彼此之间有不同的观点，但是我们依然在理解这些观点之后呢，依然可以很好的相处。And
it's also important to understand because we're different, we have different reasons for doing things.
而且呢，我们也非常重要的需要理解，就是由于我们之间的不同的这个特征，所以说呢，我们有不同的方式去做事情。
And just because I do it a certain way doesn't mean I'm right.
但是呢，并不是因为我是以这样的方式做这个事儿，所以说呢，我就是对的。
So I will stop here. Thank you all for listening. Hare Krishna.
我现在就停在这儿, 非常感谢大家聆听, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Mahatma Prabhu. So we'll open it up to questions now. I see a couple of devotees have posted something already. So I'm going to hand this part over to Krishna Das Prabhu.
是这样的啊，我现在呢就非常感谢大家的讲述。然后呢，我看到我们的对话框里面已经有一些奉献者已经提了一些评述或者问题。现在呢，我们就请 Krishna Das Prabhu 来主持下面的这一部分。
And just to get it rolling, just to get the whole thing rolling, he can ask the first question, and then, you know, from the audience of devotees, then we can take additional questions.
那我们就是为了让我们的这个节目继续下去哈，我们先请 Krishna Das Prabhu 先抛出第一个问题，然后呢，我们再回答在对话框中的其他的问题。
Hare Krishna，先。 说一下，就是我们欢迎所有的奉献者提问，只要是跟今天的这个话题相关的问题都可以提出来。同时的话呢，因为我们的这个提问呢是想要解决或者是说理清心中的一些疑惑，那所有的问题可以提问，涉及到这个合作和这个团结的问题都可以问。但是，请大家记住，就是对事不对人。 所以大家待会儿问问题的时候呢，会有一些实际的案例，就可以像刚才马哈奇讲的那样子，说是某人或者是某事就好，不要把这些名字说出来。我们不是想要在这里说开批判大会，或者是制造一些新的麻烦。谢谢。然后我第一个问题呢是想请问一下尼什格马哈奇，像今天。 三位灵性导师在这里所分享的一切，所给予的这些训示，其实我们这么多年下来，已经重复又重复强调了很多次，我们需要合作，需要团结。但实际上在日常的这个服务当中的话呢，我们会看到，其实不但是说不同的灵性导师之的门徒之间有很多的这个。 不一定是争斗了，但至少可能是这种团结和合作的心态呢，并不是或者是态度呢，并不是那么强烈。除此之外呢，甚至同一位灵性导师的门徒之间，也有很多的这种不合作运动。我们秉承的马哈帕布的不合作运动，所以呢，即便是在一个同样的灵性导师的门徒之间，也会。 经常发生这样的事情，那其实对于很多奉献者来讲呢，是造成了这个很大的失落，甚至他们会觉得说，为什么一个灵修的社团，但是比起外部世界可能还要糟糕？那我们应该怎么样去，就是有些什么样的方法可以去帮助我们所有这些奉献者能够改变自己的心态，调整自己的状态？ 能够真正达成这个求同存异，一起去服务我们的灵性导师和 Krishna， 谢谢。如果您说还是我说？您说。
Okay，firstly， Krishna Das Prabhu he welcomed everyone to join the sangha， and he also set up some rules for the devotees who are posting the questions。 That is so. I just skipped that part because that is for the Chinese devotees. And then Prabhu addressed a question to Nisimha Maharaj. He said that actually for the unity and cooperation, this teaching has already been given for years. And this has been repeated many, many times for all of the teachings from to us. However, the reality is that we see for the disciples among the different gurus, sometimes they have some problems to cooperate with each other, not necessarily to be fight with each other, but they don't have the spirit of cooperating. But even among the disciples of the same guru, we also sometimes stay aloof or stay indifferent to cooperate with the project to serve our Guru Maharaj. So in this case, what to do to encourage the devotees to really understand that, so we need to stay unity and also be cooperative with each other.
Yes. Well, I think that the important point
is... So this is a question for Nisinghar Maharaj.
Okay. Am I still muted? Yeah. Oh. Okay. Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
I would say that the solution to this is more discussion of this topic of cooperation. We have to repeatedly remind people, just like the concept that we're not the body, is something which Srila Prabhupada spoke on again and again, over and over, because it's so important, but at the same time it's so difficult for us to fully appreciate and to apply. So in the same way, we have to also understand the importance of cooperation. We have to hear again and again about the need for this cooperation.
那么这个关于合作的这个话题呢，虽然我们在反复的讲，但是呢，依然还是需要在不断的重复。就好像说了，帕帕他不断的在向我们重复着我们不是这个躯体一样，但虽然说我们听到了，可是我们依然还是能够非常的理解。 所以说呢，我们就不断的去聆听。那么就所以同样也就用在这个关于合作这件事情上。那我们要不断的去聆听合作的重要性，以及我们不断的去聆听我们如何能够做到合作以及合作的必要性。
And we have to also be willing to instruct people, point out to them if they're showing an uncooperative mood, if they're doing things in an uncooperative manner, it has to be addressed.
而且呢，就是当人们处在一个不合作的这种心态之下的时候呢，我们其实是需要向他指出的，他们是需要被告知的。We
have to point out to devotees that this is not the proper mood, that we don't want to encourage this kind of dealings.
那我们必须要告诉奉献者们，这并不是一个恰当的心态，就是这样的方式不是去处理问题的方式。And
we have to be able to come up with some solution that what could be done to make it more cooperative. What would be the actual positive way of doing the thing with to avoid this uncooperative attitude in dealings.
而且呢，我们也需要找到一些解决问题的方法，如何去解决不合作的这种心态，然后去把这个局面给扭转过来。So
communication is very important. We have to address the issue, and the issue may not just be something which is addressed to only one person, but we can address it to the assembly of devotees. Without mentioning any individual's name, we can mention to the devotees that as devotees, we certainly don't want to do things in this way, and we want to avoid this manner.
而且呢，这个沟通就是非常重要的一件事情了。那么，当我们在指出这个问题的时候呢，不一定非得指出某一个特定的奉献者来提出他的名字，而是向整个
It's a difficult task. We know that we often teach in the discourse about the need for cooperation, and Prabhupada's in the center, and we're all following Srila Prabhupada and the importance of unity. And we shouldn't canvass for people. We shouldn't canvass for people to become disciples of our guru. That shouldn't be done. These things should be avoided. But still, it happens again and again.
那么，这并不是一个容易完成的，在一起合作共同的完成事情。而且呢，也不要让这个奉献者之间有任何的分派别的这样的情况的出现。但是呢，就即便是我们这样不断的在讲，但是依然还会有这样的事情会发生。
So we have to be patient, and we have to be determined at the same time, and continue repeating again and again that we don't want to do it this way, we want to do it properly, we want proper communication, proper cooperation, proper unity.
所以说呢，我们就必须要很有耐心，但与此同时呢，我们要不断的继续的重复，然后要指出就是这么做是不对的，那我们要有恰当的合作，我们有恰当的团结。
So maybe Giri Hari Maharaj or Mahatma Prabhu would like to contribute to this question.
Giridhar Maharaj 和 Mahatma Prabhu 对于这一个问题有没有更多的说法呢？
Maharaj, you want to go first?
I appreciate everything that Nrisimha Maharaj said. Certainly all true, and go a long way to avoiding some of these problems.
那我非常赞赏刚才Nrisimha Maharaj所说的所有的这些点，而且呢也都是事实。那我们呢要尽量的去避免所发生的这些事情。
Kali Yuga, of course, is characterized by quarrel and hypocrisy.
那当然，卡利年代它的特征呢就是纷争以及虚伪。
So we always have that kind of negative energy to contend with.
那所以说呢，我们总是会持有着一些负面的能量。
No one is immune.
就没有任何一个人是免疫的。
So we're going to have to make a real effort to avoid being contaminated by, pushed by these lower energies.
所以说呢，要想避免这些低等的能量被我们的推动，我们还真的得下点功夫。
But I was also thinking of Prabhupada's statement.
那我也在想，说帕帕讲的一句话。
That example is better than precept.
那么他说呢，以身作则的榜样要比说教更强。
That the example that devotees set occupying positions as diksha gurus, shiksha gurus, mentors of any sort, that speaks volumes.
那么这个奉献者们，无论作为起定一性导师、宣示灵性导师，或者是我们的这个指导者，那么他们其实给我们设立的这个榜样是很有说服力的。
So the actions, our actions have to match our words.
那所以说我们的行为必须要符合我们的话语。
And, devotees, they will watch what the seniors do. If the seniors themselves are behaving properly, if they have cooperation and unity amongst themselves, they will go a long way to helping the more junior devotees to want to follow. If they see good examples, it will be much easier for them. And if they see negative examples, it's going to be very difficult.
因为呢，所有的这些年长奉献者，他们的行为举止全都被小奉献者们看着呢。就如果这些年长奉献者们自己之间是能够彼此很好的团结合作的话，那么就更有益的是追随他们的奉献者去追随他们的足迹。但如果要是这些年长奉献者彼此之间都有争斗，那么就很难使下面的奉献者去追随了。
So I echo the point that Nrisimha Maharaj said earlier, also repeated by Mahaprabhu, that these sanghas in which we can come together like this are so powerful. As this is going on, Chandrasekhar Prabhu sent me a message privately. He said we could expand this. We could have, many other seniors come on here, and it doesn't have to be just kept to those devotees who are serving in China. But you know, this is an international organization. There are so many wonderful Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis out there we can include. Because really what we're trying to do here is foster a family mood, because we're all family, you know, and we're all trying to cooperate, unify to serve Prabhupada. So the more we can bring everyone together, you know, the better it will be.
那么趁着西克法布他在私下给我发了一个信息，就说呢，如果要是这个是一个很好的一个作为方式的话，那我们其实可以把它扩展开来，就不仅仅是邀请在中国传教的这些年长的奉献者，而且呢，我们也可以邀请在整个世界各地的所有的这些年长的这些奉献者们来参加我们这样的这种活动。原因就是我们现在其实大家都是属于一个大的家庭，而且我们呢是在培养着一个大家庭的这种心态，所以呢，我们所有的人其实在一起都是为了要以舍罗帕帕为中心来服务他的这个运动。
And we could and we should include not only the fair-skinned, blue-eyed personalities, but devotees from all over the world, and many we have many wonderful senior Chinese devotees.Also be, they should be part of this.
还有呢，就是我们邀请的奉献者之中呢，并不仅仅是有着蓝眼睛、白皮肤的西方的奉献者。那么我们应该邀请的是世界各地的奉献者，而且呢，在中国也有非常优秀的、非常卓越的年长奉献者们。那么他们也都应该是被邀请之列的。
Those were my thoughts, Mahatma Prabhu.
My
thoughts are your thoughts, and the Sringa Maharaj's thoughts. And the thought I like the most is the fact that we're doing it right now.
that
we're doing this.
Mahaprabhu 说呢，我的想法就是您的想法也是，就是我同意您和尼辛哈马尔之所说的，而且我现在特别开心的一点就是我们现在真的是在做这件事情了。
There's two things I could comment on, both what you've already said. That by having this meeting, it gives an opportunity for the devotees to hear what their spiritual master wants them to do, that they're not happy when they create a division. They're not happy when they don't hear from others.
那我在这儿呢，就是想评注两点，就是刚才您已经讲过的。那么通过今天的这个联谊呢，使得奉献者们可以听到他们咕噜的心声，能够知道咕噜在我们引起分歧以及不听其他人的这个意见的时候，咕噜内心是觉得不开心的。
What I would suggest, I don't know if we can do it tonight, but for those devotees who have been challenged to work together and cooperate, I think,they should tell us what their challenges are so we can address them, because I think that's extremely important. Maybe they want to cooperate, but they don't really know how to do it. They're challenged to do it, we could discuss those points.
那我想在今天的这一节讲课的这个过程中呢，可能做不了这件事情，但是我想有机会我们可以这样做一下，就是那些在团结和合作有困难的奉献者，他们是不是可以把您的这个困难点向我们提出？也许可能大家是非常想要合作的，但是呢，他不知道该怎么去合作，不知道怎么和大家来团结。
And also, like you said, and we're discussing tonight, hearing why cooperation is important, of primary importance, is extremely valuable, because I think a lot of devotees maybe don't realize how important it is in Prabhupada's priorities.
而且呢，我们在这里面也就今天晚上的这个，就今天的这个活动呢，让我们听到了这个团结的重要性。因为有很多奉献者其实并不知道这个团结有多么的重要。那这是，团结是把舍罗帕帕的放在了我们重中之重的位置。
Anyway, I would be interested in hearing some of the challenges devotees are having in working better together.
但是呢，我觉得我很有兴趣的想知道这个奉献者们所面对的在团结的时候遇到的这个困难到底是什么，然后我们可以一起来 把这个问题解决。
If not tonight, another time.
如果是今天我们做不到这一点的话呢，那我们可以找别的时间来一起来完成。
Hare Krishna. So I see there's a number of questions that have been written in the chat box. Sati Maniji, you want to help Dana Kaili organize them?
Hare Krishna, 稍等一下。阿叔想讲几句。Sati, 把阿叔解除静音。Krishna, 把电话。
我已经给阿叔。
And they don't live in temples, and that creates more difficulty in establishing unity. And they prefer to have unity and diversity. They prefer having more sangha amongst their god siblings. And naturally, the Diksha Guru is the center of their gatherings. One thing we did in the beginning, perhaps you remember. Translate this.
Sorry.那我因为是一开始就参加了咱们今天的这个活动，所以说呢我都听到了各位老师的讲述，所以呢我很同意大家的这个说法。那么刚才我也听到了我们所抛出的这个问题，就是为什么这个关于合作这个问题是老生常谈的问题，可是为什么我们现在依然还面临着这么多的考验呢？原因就是由于没有我们的这个一起来参与的这个庙啊，或者是这个中心的这个设施，以至于呢，就使得这些奉献者们就愿意只是留在自己的小范围内的这个三个联谊的这个活动里面，跟自己的神姐妹、神兄弟在一起来服务自己的灵性导师，这是其中的一个原因。
And as it was mentioned, I think by Giri, that is Swami Mahatma Prabhu.It's not just a local thing in China, in this region, it's all over the world.
而且呢，迪达尔马尔这还有马哈拉马跑步也都提到了，这并不是咱们中国唯一所面临的问题，是整个世界所面临的问题。
One of the main reasons that we never really establish in our society the importance of shiksha.
那么其中有一个主要的原因呢，就是因为我们没有真正的建立起我们的社团，并且呢强调 Shiksha 训师的重要性。
The importance of Shiksha Gurus.
对，就没有强调 Shiksha Guru 们的重要性。
Yeah, from the very beginning after Srila Prabhupada's departure, I remember having a talk with Satvarupa Maharaj, and we talked about this, and he actually wrote an article about the importance of.Establishing in our society this consciousness of having Shiksha Gurus, not just Diksha Guru.
那么在Srila Prabhupada离世之后呢，我记得我们还和这个 which Maharaj
Satsvarupa Maharaj.
Satsvarupa Maharaj. 然后我们探讨的这个话题，其实呢，他还写了一个这个文章，就是关于
Completely addressed.
但是呢，这个问题呢，就一直都没有得到解决，没有得到解决。
I mean, those of us we joined at the time of Srila Prabhupada, we knew that Srila Prabhupada we would have his darshan a very seldom, very few opportunities to ask him a question or write him a letter. But we felt protected by being guided by his senior disciples.
在我们后来加入运动的舍拉帕帕的门徒呢，其实我们是很难得到舍拉帕帕的信，或者是得到舍拉帕帕的亲身的 darshan 的。但是我们感到自己是被保护的原因呢，是由于我们是被舍拉帕帕的早期的年长的门徒保护着。
So, yes, any senior disciple, I remember any senior god brother was my shiksha guru.
而且呢，我们都记得任何一位。年长的奉献者，那年长的这个神兄弟、神兄都是我的 Shiksha Guru。
And some were really very, very important Shiksha Gurus。
而且呢，有一些神兄都是我非常重要，都是我们非常重要的 Shiksha Guru。
Okay, understood. This was easier in a temple atmosphere to create this type of situation.
那么但是呢，就是由于我们有庙的这样的氛围，所以说呢，能够更好的营造这样的气氛。
I remember when we in the beginning of our mission here, only Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj was initiating.
那我记得就是我们早期在中国的时候呢，只有 Tamal Krishna Goswami Maharaj 他才可以起立，他在起立。
But then when they decided that was time for other devotees to initiate to, like Narasingha Maharaj, Giridhari Maharaj and others, and then at that time it was established that the disciples, they would have the pictures of all the gurus in their altars.
那后来呢，就因为有了尼辛格玛尔吉还有迪达尔玛尔吉也都可以起迪了，但是当时的规矩就是所有的这些起迪门徒他们要把所有的这些灵性导师的照片都放在他们的神坛上。
And I really appreciate that because it really it creates physically a mood of cooperation because they were worshipping the other gurus as their shiksha gurus.
那么这其实是一个非常好的做法，我非常赞赏的做法，就是因为这么做呢，就使得营造了一种非常的合作的气氛。他们在崇拜的时候，不仅崇拜了自己的启迪灵性导师，而且崇拜了所有的这些宣誓灵性导师。
I guess because of space and more gurus, you know, joining in, you know, would not have the space to have all those people, all photos of the all gurus in the altar. But we still could have something like, you know, a small corner in of the altar or outside of the altar, a place where they could have the pictures of all the gurus initiating, if that is safe and if everything would be okay, accepted. So they would be reminded, yes, all these initiating gurus are also my shiksha gurus, and I respect them equally as I respect my diksha guru.
但是我想呢，由于我们的启迪灵性导师越来越多，以至于我们的这个神坛上可能就摆不下所有的这些启迪灵性导师的照片了。但我想，我们有一个很好的做法，就是在安全这个范围内，我们应该设立一个很小的一个区域，然后在这个区域里面呢，放下所有的这些启迪灵性导师的照片，从而呢，能够提醒我们所有的这些灵性导师都是我们的宣誓灵性导师，当我们在崇拜他们的时候。
This is perhaps something practical that we could reestablish, you know, having they could have the even if tiny photos, you know, somewhere in where they offer Guru Puja, you know, to have all these Shiksha Gurus together, all these different gurus initiating in China together would be a good reminder that we belong all to the same family and they all are important to us, either my Diksha Guru or these Shiksha Gurus here, they're all important. So it eliminates a little bit of this guru groupism.
那所以这个呢，应该是一个比较可行的一个做法，就是当我们在进行 guru puja 的时候，当我们在进行崇拜的时候呢，我们就可以崇拜我们的就是所有的这些灵性导师们，然后让我们记得我们都是属于一个大家庭里面的所有的这个成员。那这样就能够削弱我们的这个。
Family of gurus.
那么这就是我们有一个家庭的 guru.
Okay, that's all I wanted to say. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
那这些都是我想说的，非常感谢有这样的机会。
So we have some questions now. So in order to save time.We won't have each of our three speakers answer each question, otherwise not many questions will get answered.
那就是由于我们这个时间有限哈，所以说呢，我们这个问题呢就不是请每一位灵性导师都进行解答了，否则的话我们就没有办法回答所有的这些问题了。第一个问题是来自于 Rodan. So, Prabhu, can we go through the questions from the chat room now?
Go ahead.
Okay, 那我们先来。
等等，给你慢点进。我把一些问题我私信贴给你了，你看一下就可以了哈。
好，我看一下啊。要不然你能不能发给我的微信呢？你这个私信里面我看到好像就只有一个是吧？就加爱的问题是吧？您只给我发了给我了一个是吗？
您先， 您看到你们先说吧，然后
我只看到就是
大概。
OK， 我只看到了加亚的问题，现在是加亚的问题哈。Hare Krishna Maharaj， Hare Krishna Prabhuji， 我 my humble obeisances unto you all, all glories to Srila Prabhupada and all his sincere followers. Thank you very much for your kind explanation. I am a neophyte devotee, don't know much about Krishna consciousness. From my own immature understanding that cooperation and unity requires more purity. The false ego blocked us from unity. There was two servants can cooperate to serve the master, but the two masters will be difficult to cooperate to do something. Devotees need to learn and practice to put Krishna and Srila Prabhupada is in the center instead of our service. Actually, I am far from level of cooperate with other devotees, but I hope by the mercy of Guru and Srila Prabhupada, I can reach that platform at the future. 这是来自于加雅的一个评述，他说呢 ，Hare Krishna Maharaj, Hare Krishna Prabhuji， 我谦卑的顶拜所有的奉献者，一切的荣耀都归于Srila Prabhupada以及他非常真诚的追随者们。非常感谢你们仁慈的解释。我是一个初级的奉献者，我并不懂太多的关于 Krishna 知觉的信息。从我自己的不成熟的理解来看，合作和团结需要更多的纯粹。那么假我把我们给挡住了，使得我们没有办法团结。那么有两个仆人，他们可以一起来服务他们的老师。但是呢，但是这两个人呢，他们又很难一起合作做一些事情。那奉献者就需要学习以及习练，把 Krishna 和 Srila Prabhupada 放在他们的中间，而不是把自己放在中间。事实上，我自己处于还远远的不能够和其他的奉献者一起合作的层面。但是我希望，急着 Guru 和 Srila Prabhupada 的仁慈。我可以在将来达到这个层面。
Giridhari Swami, could you take that one, please?
I'm not really clear what the question was.
It's not, sorry, Maharaj, she's not addressing a question, it's only a comment.
Oh, okay, that's
good. I could say something. I could say one thing.
Go ahead,
Prabhu.
She was saying that cooperation takes purity, and she, you know, the false ego is always an obstacle, and she doesn't feel like she's, you know, that pure yet to be able to cooperate.
因为在这里面呢，他就讲到了，就是合作呢是需要纯洁，是要有纯粹的。但是由于这个假我呢，总是挡住了合作的这个路，因为他还没有那么的纯粹去进行合作。
Actually, I'm not sure it's a she.
我们并不知道这位奉献，我们并不知道这位奉献者到底是一位 Prabhu 还是一位 Mataji.
But Jiva Goswami addressed a question. Do you need humility to practice bhakti, or will you get humility when you advance, or is humility just the inherent ingredient of prema, and so when you have prema, you'll get it.
那么，是 Jiva Goswami 他就回答了这个问题。他就说呢，就当我们在习练 bhakti 的时候，我们是否需要谦卑，还是这个谦卑它其实就是已经在 bhakti 里面的，在 prema 里面。如果我们要是去习练的话，其实我们就自动的会得到谦卑了。
So his answer was all three are true.
那所以说呢，这个答案就是都是对的。
So the point is, I may not be humble, but it means still I should act in a humble way, even if I'm not humble.
那这个答案就是，也许我现在并不谦卑，我现在还没有谦卑，但是呢，我也要以谦卑的方式去行事。
So if I need to be right, that's not humble.
那如果我需要，如果我需要得到自己的权利的话，这不是谦卑。
If I don't take time to understand others' points of view, then I'm not acting humbly.
那如果我要是 想要花这个时间去，就是我需要得到别人对我的认可的话，那这也不是谦卑。
If I refuse to only cooperate if people accept my opinion, then I'm not acting humbly.
那如果我要是只和那些同意我的意见的人去团结合作的话，那这也不是谦卑。
So the point is, I may not be humble, but I can act in those ways because that's what Prabhupada wants me to do.
但是这个要点就在于，我现在也许还不能够谦卑，但是呢，我要让自己谦卑的去行事的原因，是因为这是释迦牟尼佛想让我做的。
And you know, we could use the example of a devotee who doesn't take a bath.
我们可以举一个不沐浴的奉献者的例子。
And you ask him why, and he says, "Well, when I become Krishna conscious, I'll be clean."
那你问他你为什么不沐浴啊？他说，因为我当我有了 Krishna 知觉之后呢，我就会变得干净了。
Okay, we know that's stupid.
那我们知道这其实是特蠢的一说法。
So when I become Krishna conscious, I'll be humble. But if we don't act humbly, how are we going to become humble? How are we going to become Krishna conscious?
那所以说呢，就是我现在还没有谦卑。但是呢，如果我要是不谦卑的话，我怎么能够变得具有 Krishna 知觉呢？
Thank you.
谢谢。
Just on that point, you know, Prabhupada was asked, you know, how can one develop humility?
就这一点呢，释迦牟尼佛曾经被提及怎么能够培养出谦卑。
And as he often answered questions of this sort.He said, that's in your hand. That's in your hand. You want to be humble? You can be humble.
那释迦牟尼佛经常会这样回答这个问题。他说呢，这其实取决于你，就在你的手里面。如果你要想让自己变得谦卑的话，你就能谦卑。
So, you know, we have a choice. We have a choice at every moment.
那所以我们在每一个时刻都是有一个选择的。
So we should choose wisely.
那所以我们应该很有智慧地做出选择。
Maharaj, there's another way to become humble. It's quite easy. Just get married. You have no choice.
Maharaj, 还有另外一个可以让自己变得谦卑下来的方式，就是结婚，然后你就没有选择了。
No, I'm not advising you to get married. But if you are,
但是我没有说建议你要结婚。
So I've been told.
Yeah. Quite easy when you're married.
马尔说呢，我也被人家这个这么告知过。然后马哈拉玛帕布说呢，当你结婚了以后呢，就很容易让自己变得谦卑下来了，很容易的方式。So the next one.
这就你是拉班格拉丽卡问的，就是对于那些已经不合作的。地方那些主和主之间老死不相往来，这种情况如何改善？
Yeah, this question is from Labanga Latika Maji. Her question is that, for those areas, for those uncooperated areas, because some of the groups they have no ways to be together and cooperate with each other, how to improve that situation?
Dara Shinga Maharaj, can you take that one, please?
They have no way to be together, so how can they cooperate with each other?
Yeah. The groups, for some reason, they just don't want to do anything together at all.
They don't want to do anything together.
How to make them together?
Yes.
They have to...
Well,They need to, in order to understand the importance of cooperation, they should understand that their individuality does not have to be lost.
Okay, 就是首先呢，就是他们需要去了解，合作是多么的重要。但与此同时呢，也要让他们知道，就是他们自己的这个个体性是不需要被封锁起来的。
The flair of an individual shouldn't be stifled.
那所以说呢，就是自己的这种个体性不应该被扼杀掉。
So it's encouraging them to develop the mode of having respect for each other.
所以说呢，要鼓励这些人们要培养出对彼此的尊敬之情。
As we heard, we've been hearing from various people, the cause of the disunity and the cause of the mood of not wanting to cooperate is because we want to be the supreme, we want to be independent, we want to be, you know, the false ego is very strong.
那当时刚才我们也听到了，就是之所以大家不想团结以及不想合作的原因呢，是由于我们想要成为控制者，我们想要成为至尊，那么我们的这个假我是非常的强悍的。
But the whole purpose of Krishna consciousness is developing the mood of being the servant. So having the mood of being the servant is something which we have to always emphasize more and more. We have to show that example to others also, that the leaders are all servants.
但是呢，这个Krishna 智慧的精髓就在于我们要培养出我们是这个 Krishna 智慧的这个精髓就在于我们是仆人。那么这个呢是要不断的被强调的，而且呢是要让大家去了解的，而且我们也需要作为领导是以身作则的去向大家去展示，领导他就是仆人。
So we want to encourage people. We do want to encourage individuals. We don't want them to feel that they're going to lose the opportunity to show their individuality. We want to encourage them as individuals.
是一个很好的方法。那之前我们可以把奉献者带到圣地的时候，特别是在节日期间，有很多奉献者来到圣地的时候，这对于很多奉献者来说都是一个让自己谦卑下来的体验。
Coming to the holy dam, we would see devotees from all over the world, all different nationalities, all different levels of devotees.
因为当我们来到圣地之后呢，我们就可以见到世界各地的奉献者，而且呢也能够接触到处在各种层面上的奉献者。
And generally, just coming into that kind of atmosphere, we will feel happy to be a part of such an organization which is so vast and has so much variety.
那么通常来说呢，当我们置身在这样的环境里面的时候，我们会感到很开心。当我们处在如此浩瀚的节日里面，而且呢有这么多的国家的人都来参与到这个大的节日里面。
So that's my solution to these people who want to be individuals, who want to be, they don't want to cooperate with others. I think it's very important for them to visit the Holy Dham.And to come into the association of the international community of devotees.
那所以这是我的这个意见，就是对于想要就是不想和其他的人一起合作的这些人，给他们的意见呢，就是请他们到圣地，然后呢到圣地去看一看，整个的这个社团，来自世界各地的这个社团如何在一起合作的这样的氛围。
Yeah.Anybody else like to contribute?
Maharaj, I think we'll just move on to another question.
Okay.
那我们现在就看下面这个问题哈。
然后后面有一个问题是问向 Gitar Swami 提问的，就是说如果是作为一个新人，万一这么不幸的处于这种不合作运动的氛围之中的话。
So this question is from a devotee to Giridhara Maharaj, and the question is that for a new devotee, if very unfortunately to be trapped in the non-cooperative environment, what is the best way for this devotee to protect him or herself?
Okay. Well, there are all levels of, you know, cooperation or lack of it.
那么有各种层级的合作以及缺少合作，各种 各种层级的缺少合作。
But if we're caught in such a situation, of course we can seek the guidance of our seniors.
那当然，如果我们要是不幸跌在这样的一种状态下的话呢，那我们就应该从我们的长者那里去寻求指导。
We can try ourselves to foster the mood of cooperation. I mean, by the things that we say and the things that we do.
而且呢，我们也从自己做起，我们通过自己所说的话以及自己所做的事情来培养自己的合作的精神。
Again, I want to echo what we said earlier, you know, that statement of Prabhupada that example is better than precept.
那我现在还想这个应和，就是重复一下刚才我们所说的话。释迦牟尼佛讲的就是我们的以身作则比说教要更加的有力量。
We may doubt what difference can one individual make.
那我们也许可能对于某一个人的行为表感到很困惑。
But if you think, you know, just like if you throw a stone into a body of water, you know, it hits in one place, but then it has like a rippling effect. So if you start setting a good example yourself by the way that you speak and the way that you act, it will certainly have a positive influence on others. And so, okay, it influences one other person, another person, and pretty soon, you know, it spreads. So if you want to see a change, then you should be part of that change.
那么就好像我们把一个小石子儿给扔到水里面一样，那么这会儿呢，这个小石子落到水里面以后，它就会引起这个水波的这个涟漪。那么就好像我们自己如果要是有很好的行为举止，有很好的言语的话，那我们其实就可以通过我们的行为举止去影响到身边其他的人，然后呢，不断的就像这个水波的涟漪一样，去影响越来越多的人，越来越多的人。
There may be a tendency just to depend on someone else, or he or she will do.
但是也许可能我们的这种倾向就是，哎呀，反正我要依靠其他的人，他或者就是其他的人他会做到这一点的，他会做的。
Problem is everyone else may be thinking the same thing.
但问题就是，也许可能所有的人都是这么想的。
He or she will do it.
他或者他会做的。
And the net result is no one does anything.
但这个造成的结果呢，就变成了没有任何一个人会做任何事情了。
So we need some initiative ourselves.
那所以说呢，我们自己要主动的做一些事情。
Again, we can draw strength from our seniors. We can inquire from them. We can certainly explain such a situation, ask their advice. But we have to learn to take some initiative ourselves.
当然了，我们也可以去请教我们的长者，去把我们的这个情况，去和长者去进行探讨，然后呢，去得到他的指导。但是我们
just choose one.
Okay. 这个 Lila 婆婆说呢，是个德行问题。如果德行不够，还想控制别人，就会散布说不合作、纷争，只是 GBC 们任命了德行不够的领导造成的。Lila 婆婆 said that, actually, this is a question about morality.Oh, no, sorry, this is not the one. 团结和不团结，合作与不合作的问题，用毛主席话来说就是政治。
Hare Krishna, Tanakriya Mandaji, 我来读一个问题吧。
Sati Mataji, you should take care of this. You read the questions, because Tanakriya Mataji is translating...And she can't find the questions, it's confusing. So or Krishnadas Prabhu should be responsible for this part. Read out the questions that can be answered. Go ahead.
Okay. 前面潘智塔的帕布提了一个问题，就是说我们如何面对虚伪纷争破坏团结的所谓的奉献者。
Okay. This question is Panchatattva Prabhu. He said that what is the right way to face...those so-called devotees who is actually very very hypocritically to break the unity, break the unity of the society.
Mahaprabhu, you can please begin with this one.
It's quite a loaded question, because making an assumption they're not devotees.
这其实是挺，这是这个问题，感觉好像就是这并不是奉献者做的事儿。Wait,
Dhananakali Mataji, I think you translated that wrong. I think Prabhu said the question is a little bit. The questioner is making an assumption that such people are not devotees. That's their assumption.
Okay, okay, 就是这个问题呢，好像就是做出了一种假设，就是假设这不是奉献者。
Which in itself would cause a lot of divisiveness to think that way.
但是呢，就是这个问题本身就这样的想法呢，其实它就产生了很多的这个分歧。So,
are you saying they don't agree with you, and they're causing problems because they don't agree with you? I'm not sure what you're saying.
那其实我其实并不是特别的这个确认你在这里面说的是什么，你在说的就是因为他们不同意您的意见，所以说呢，他们就在引这个导致问题吗？
Because that's the essential cause of dissension. You don't agree with me, so I don't want to work with you. Or I
don't.
But if what you say is true, and these people are creating difficulty wherever they go, then they should be avoided.
但是呢，如果要是您说的这是真的，就是说，我这个人他所到之处都会制造麻烦的话，那么这样的人就应该避免去和他接触。One
of the problems we have is when we're dealing with difficult people, we sometimes then become difficult ourselves. We kind of end up doing what they're doing to try to deal with them.
那这个问题就在于，当我们有的时候在应对很难搞的人的时候，慢慢我们自己在应对这些难搞的人的时候，就把自己也变成了一个很难搞的人。So
I don't know the specifics you're talking about, so it's a little difficult to answer.
所以说呢，我其实并不是特别的理解您的这个问题背后所传递的信息，所以呢，有点难回答。
Not a little difficult. It's kind of impossible for me because I don't know the situation.
其实呢，并不是说是对我来说有一点难回答，是根本就没法回答的原因，是因为我不知道这个具体的情况是怎么回事。
I mean, are these people trying to destroy the movement? Or are they going around criticizing all the leaders? Is that what you're referring to?
那您是不是讲的是就是这些人他们？ 试图要毁掉我们的这个运动，然后呢，到处去讲这些领导的坏话，是吗？
Yeah, if that's the case, certainly we need to protect the movement and protect the devotees from them.
那如果要是这样的一种情况的话，那我们就要去保护我们的这个运动，并且保护参与其中的奉献者了。
I was just questioning that assumption you're making.
How
is it accurate, or is it just the way you see it? But I think 把以帕帕德为中心的态度传递给门徒呢？
Now one of the devotees said that how the spiritual masters to convey their convictions and their faith of their love to Srila Prabhupada to their disciples.
Narasingha Maharaj, could you answer this one, please?
I would say they have to show this in the course of their preaching, that they're constantly preaching about Srila Prabhupada.
Maharaj, you're muted.
Oh, sorry.
Maharaj, you're muted.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. I would suggest that when they're in the course of their preaching, they refer to Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada's actions, Srila Prabhupada's examples, Srila Prabhupada's pastimes.
那么我的建议呢，就是当他们在进行传教的时候，在进行讲课的时候呢，他们一定要提及舒拉帕帕的教导，团结舒拉帕帕的行为以及舒拉帕帕的小时光。
We want to constantly refer to Srila Prabhupada. What would Srila Prabhupada do in this situation? And give examples how Prabhupada would react in different situations, what Prabhupada said, how he instructed devotees.
那我们要恒常不断地去讲述舒拉帕帕所处在的这个处境，以及他如何去应对在这个处境中的这个方式，以及呢他是怎么去向奉献者们去传教的，去怎么训示这些奉献者们的。
So it's very helpful for devotees if they read the different books put out by our different biographers describing Srila Prabhupada, Harisori's diary, Satsvarupa Maharaj's Lilamrita, Shruta Kirti's book, and so many other books all about Prabhupada.
所以说呢，我们就鼓励着奉献者去阅读关于Srila Prabhupada的这个生平事迹的这些传记。 比如说像 Harisori Prabhu 还有 Satsvarupa Maharaj Goswami 还有像 Shukrakriti Prabhu 他们都写了很多的关于Srila Prabhupada传记的书籍。
It's very nice also to read Prabhupada's Vyasa Puja books every year, try to read some of the offerings.
还有一个很好的做法呢，就是去阅读每年所发行的Srila Prabhupada的Vyasa Puja的手册。
We want to constantly remind devotees about Prabhupada's instructions, what Prabhupada expected us to do. Alright, okay, I'll stop there.
这是我的回答。
好，下一个问题，请问，Girdhara Maharaj， 作为门徒，如何把帕帕德置于自己灵性修习中心，并且高于自己启迪咕噜的地位呢
？So this question addressed to Girdhara Maharaj. My question is that as a disciple, how can I place Srila Prabhupada in the center of my practice? I place him in the place even more exalted than my home Diksha Guru.
Well, I think we have to understand that Prabhupada's in a very, very special position. I mean, he's the founder Acharya of our society. You know, if we mistakenly think he's just another guru in disciplic succession, now we have an incorrect understanding. I mean, as Diksha or any other devotee who's given us Shiksha, we can.
这就并不意味着我们就不要向我们给我们启迪的启迪灵性导师以及给我们训示的一些奉献者以尊敬以及我们的仰慕之情了。That
has to be in relation to Srila Prabhupada.
我们是需要去敬仰仰慕他们的，但是呢，所有的这些都必须是要和Srila Prabhupada相连接在一起的。
The problem comes if we try to separate our allegiance to a particular Diksha Guru, you know, consciousness of Prabhupada, all that he is, you know, all that he did, all that he continues to do. It should occupy the central point of one's life.
那么就好像刚才尼辛瓦马尔达所讲的那样，我们应该更多的去阅读关于薛罗帕帕的生平传记。那么有这么多优秀的奉献者们，他们写了关于薛罗帕帕的非常美好的这些记事，那我们就应该时刻的去阅读，并且让自己有更好的薛罗帕帕的这个知觉，去意识到薛罗帕帕在他这一生中都做了些什么，他所做的这个事情的实质是什么。
It's also important to hear from those devotees who had extensive association with Srila Prabhupada, because when they open up, they open their hearts and they share that, it's wonderful.
而且呢，当我还有一件很重要的事情，就是我们应该去聆听那些和Srila Prabhupada有着非常的深厚的联谊的那些奉献者的分享。当他们敞开心扉的向我们分享这些话题的时候，是非常的美妙的。
As we've been conducting these interviews, of many, many senior devotees, this always comes out, just how Prabhupada touched their lives.
当我们在采访做的这些年长奉献者们的时候，总是会听到 Srila Prabhupada 是如何触动了他们的触动以及改变了他们的一生。
So someone who's had that experience can also share that experience with others, and that then becomes, you know, kind of like a beacon, and it points one in that direction so that one's connected with Prabhupada.
所以说有这样的体验的奉献者呢，他们是可以把这样的体验和大家分享的，从而呢就使得听到他们分享的这样的奉献者也就能够和舍罗帕帕有连接了。
Those are some points.
那这是我要说的要点。
Thank you, Maharaj. Next one. 请问 Mahatma Prabhu, 奉献者之间太忙了，以至于没有时间来聆听对方说出彼此之间的想法和需求。那么您刚才谈到了彼此有不同的观点，但还是需要理解和彼此尊重。我深受您话语的鼓舞。如果彼此不能理解，怎么谈团结合作呢？感恩您。
This question addressed to Mahatma Prabhu. Thank you very much. However, the devotees are very busy with our all kinds of things, so we don't really have time to communicate with each other and hearing the thoughts and understanding from each other. So if we are not communicate and if we don't really understand each other, so how can we really cooperate and stay unity?
You can't.
确实不行。
That's the whole problem. We don't understand one another.
整个的问题就在这儿了，因为我们没有理解彼此。
Or like you say, we don't take the time.
就好像你刚才说的那样，就是因为我们其实没有把时间花在这件事情上。
It's Kali Yuga. Misunderstanding is pervasive.
因为这是卡利年代，所以说呢，误解是无处不在的。
You know, we don't all have to agree to get along.
那其实，当我们就是彼此间在一起的时候，我不一定是要认同。
So the art of cooperation is learning how to get along with people that see things differently than we do.
那所以说呢，就是我们要学着合作，也就意味着我们需要学着去看我们是如何以不同的方式去做事情。我们要去了解别人是怎么不同的和我们就和我们不一样的这样的方法去做事。
And because Prabhupada asked us to get along, then we have to figure out how to do it.
那因为是Srila Prabhupada训练我们要彼此之间合作愉快，所以呢我们就得学着怎么去做到这件事情。
Everybody's conditioned.
所有的人都是处在条件限制中的。
By our past experiences, our culture, our upbringing.
那我们对于我们这个过往的生世，我们过去的经历，我们生活的环境，以及我们所在的文化所限制着。
And it's a real challenge to try to understand people who are different from us, but it's essentially necessary.
那当然。去了解和我们不同的人，对于我们来说是一个挑战。但是呢，就是我们 有在一起合作，就是能够在一起很平顺的在一起的这种愿望。因为当我们有了这样的愿望的时候呢，我们就能够找到方法了。
But if we just want to do everything our own way, then we're going to create trouble.
但是如果我们要是仅仅是想按自己的方式去做事情的话，那我们肯定会遇到麻烦的。
When Giridhara Swami was speaking, I was thinking another question we can ask ourselves. Are you creating more unity in ISKCON or are you creating more disunity in ISKCON?
刚才在 Giridhara Maharaj 在讲话的时候呢，我还在想另外一个问题，就是我们应该问自己一个问题，我们到底是给 ISKCON 创造了更多的团结呢，还是创造了更多的麻烦？
We should always be asking ourselves.
所以我们应该是
否 Are we trying to create more unity?
那么我们是不是能够创造更多的团结？
I can think plenty of things I could do to create disunity, but I don't let myself do it.
那我们要时刻想着我们应该做什么事情能够创造更多的团结。其实我可以想到很多的让自己，我可以想到很多的不团结的这种方式，但是呢，我肯定不会让自己去做这些事情的。
A lot of our God brothers have left this kind. That doesn't take much courage.
Sorry, Marge.
A lot of our God brothers have left ISKCON. That's kind of the easy way out.
Okay, 那我们有很多的这个神兄弟离开了 ISKCON. 那我想这可能是一个挺容易的离开的方式。
Can I read something? This is amazing.
那我想读一点东西。很不可思议。
Let's just take a minute.Prabhupada said, I've given you this big ISKCON movement. Please expand it, at least maintain it. Don't let it decrease. Please cooperate.
Srila Prabhupada 说呢，我把这ISKCON 运动给了大家，那么请你们要扩展它，至少要维系它，请不要缩减它，至少要合作。
So Prabhupada said, please cooperate. Then he started crying.
然后舍爸爸就说请合作，然后就开始哭起来了。
So there was a devotee there, and he made a comment.
那当时呢有一位奉献者在，所以他就做了个评述。
He said if there's a problem in ISKCON, just try to work to solve it.
他说呢在 ISKCON 有问题，遇到了问题，那只是努力的去解决问题。
So he saw Prabhupada crying, and this devotee said, and so if you leave ISKCON, if you don't cooperate, you make Prabhupada cry.
So because he saw Prabhupada crying, so he said, if you leave ISKCON, and you don't cooperate, you make Prabhupada cry. So knowing that, then we can see that Srila Prabhupada cry.
So knowing that, it's an impetus to figure out how we can get along better.
所以我们知道这个之后呢，这就将是我们知道怎么能够让自己做得更好的动力。
It's 9:30. We'll take one more question, I think, because we don't want to go on and on. It's 2 hours and we all have to continue our day. So one more question, Sati Mataji, and then we'll finish up.
现在是9:30了，所以说呢，我们因为在一天中还有其他的事情要做，所以我们现在呢再回答一个问题，我们今天的这个早课呢就先结束了。
好的，今天大家提出了很多评论啊，下面这个学会的问题呢是，团结是一种素质和教育，从小到大的教育链条中缺失这一块，所以在成人后每个人拥有的限制性的信念会影响到合作的深度和广度，能否请协会印制一些个人成长规划、自我管理、团结合作等比较直接和系统的资料供大家直观的去学习，旨在提高个人的素养和认知的高度，这样可能参与者的个人素养提高了，做人的格局提高了，那么看待这个团结合作的问题可能就更成熟和全面了。
算妈姐能把这发给我吗？太长了。
好，我发您那个微信上啊。
Sorry, I'm asking Sarimaji to send me this text. Unity is a kind of quality education. And however, in our material education, we're short of this. So after we've grown up, we are trapped in a kind of a conditional way of faith or belief. And so we are not able to cooperate with people in a very deep and broad way. So if it's okay to for the society to provide us some program to help us with the this is the situation, the education about cooperation and also about the self-management. In this way, we can be more straightforwardly to be trained. The reason for this is because everyone of us have our own understanding and perspective about the self-cultural development. After all of us have our own improvement about our quality, then probably we will have a better view to considering about the things or to perceive the things. We will have a better way. We will have a better way to understand an issue when the issue come out. So in that case, we will have a more mature way or more broad way to solve the problem. And in this case, can lead us to be in
the best training for unity is our Krishna conscious program. Coming from the West, we were not trained to cooperate, and we were not trained in unity. The Western culture is very revolutionary. I grew up in the 1960s. There was a lot of revolution and counterculture, and we were very much against everything. We hated the governments, we hated everything. It was all protesting.
那就刚才志伟奉献者的这个评注我有点说法哈，就是我觉得呢，就是对于团结和合作最好的培训就是在Krishna知觉中的培训。那么在西方国家里面，其实我们对于团结啊，对于合作呀，其实是没有任何的所谓系统的培训的。那我是生活在60年代，我在这个成长的这个过程中呢，其实我们就看到了有很多这种反政府、反文化，有各种各样的这种运动。
But we developed the mood of unity and cooperation by taking part in the Krishna conscious program.
但是呢，当我们加入到Krishna知觉的这些活动中的时候呢，我们就开始变得有了合作心，并且开始变得团结了。
So I have no doubt that the Krishna conscious program is the solution to all the problems of the world.
那所以说呢，我一点也不怀疑Krishna知觉的这些活动是解决在这个世界的所有的问题的方式。Hare
Krishna.
Thank you, Maharaj. Next, Mahatma Prabhu.
Yeah, I would just say that it was said that Prabhupada could build a house in which the whole world can live, but it's actually we have inherited that house.
那有这样一个说法，就是修罗帕帕他建起了一座整个世界都可以住进来的房子。那问题就是我们其实继承了这个房子。
And my conception of the house is there's different rooms, and different things going on in different rooms.
那我对于这个房子的概念呢，就是在这个房子里面有好多好多的房间，然后在每一个房间里面都有不同的事情在发生着。
And different people that they can